you're through to your garage. You, need me to bring you a ride? I'll bring it by.
Hello, chum. Now, it's your old friend.
Anything you need, boss. Oh, hi. How can I help you? Just let me know what you need.
All right, sale time. This buyer's being a little sketchy. Doesn't want to give us too much information. Head out to that general area and more details will be forthcoming. You there? Right. This guy, he's around here somewhere. 2 seconds. Yeah, okay, yeah. He's in a yellow, maybe an orange Camacho. Start looking and I'll see if I can get an exact location on this end.
I'm on the clock. What you want? Some weed? I'll get there as soon as I can. I'll get back to it then. You're through to your garage. You, need me to bring you a ride? It's coming at you. You need something, huh? One of your rides? Let me know. It's on the way.
Thank you. Sorry about the smell. Spilled a gallon of deer urine.
The Diamond Casino and Resort. Fight the evil of boredom with high-stakes gaming. Rich people truly are happier.
Thank you.
Good to see you, boss.
Dregs from Europe build Midwest chain restaurants, kill 90% of our people, and herd us into tiny pens, only letting us out to drink fire water and work construction jobs. But now, all this bliss is being ruined. Say, Paleface, got him Redwood?
Yes, I'd like a Redwood cigarette as well. Perfect for chiefs of all kinds everywhere.
For gentlemen from all walks of life.
Hmm, how?
I'd like one too, but... they're too manly for me.
Damn straight, Chippy. Hey, I don't understand what Pablo has to do with all this.
The Redskin says something terrible is coming. He thinks it's communism, Gordon, and he's not happy about it. His people could smell this stuff in the wind.
This land of freedom, not land to share equally.
What he's trying to say, Gordon, is this is a land of freedom, not a land to share equally.
I don't understand. Oh, being a woman, I can't help but stick my nose in where it doesn't belong and amble cluelessly through life. Can I fix you gentlemen a drink?
Damn straight you can, woman. Two scotches and a ceremonial bowl of water for the cheap.
I'm on wagon.
I'd use the local police force, but the fact is, Gordon, they're useless. Lone existentialist crime fighters like yourself, men with an addiction to justice. They're much better at fighting evil than government fat cats and bloated examples of America's descent into decadence.
Amen.
We think that the commies have infiltrated the moving pictures. They're writing subversive themes into scripts to influence our children and women. The fact is, there's only one kind of red we like in this country. A red skin who knows his place and wears feathers a lot while having very little understanding of syntax. Not goddamn communists.
There's communists? In Vinewood? Oh, but this used to be a nice country. Oh, Gordon, I'm scared.
I'm scared too, Molly, of what I'll do when I catch them.
Me scalp them big nasty.
All right, simmer down.
Sorry.
We'll have to find a way to sneak onto that motion picture studio lot and have a look around, see?
I knew I can count on you. Who better to protect America than a drunk? A dame in a sensitive portrayal of indigenous people.
How about we smoke on peace pipe?
Oh, yeah.
I'm in.
Okay, all right, let's get out of here. I know exactly where to start.
Are we going to the movie studio?
No, Molly, we're going in here. Can't start a case without a fisted gin. Helps a man think. Now, where to find these pinkos? Hey there, partner, where are you from?
Oh, I'm from Georgia.
Oh, I do love a peach.
Yeah, I'm real American. I sleep with sister and finger ship.
Well, no time to dilly-dally. I've got to solve this case, and I know just how to get into that movie lot.
Hey, Joey, look what I snuck for my old man.
Gadzooks, Nancy. He'll be cross for sure. You'll get a serious spanking.
Nah, he only spanks Mommy. Why should he enjoy all this refreshing flavor? Yay!
When Daddy's not looking, grab that pack. Don't worry about that cough or hack. Time to smoke, smoke, smoke really good.
It's gotta be that filter tip.
Redwood!
Yeah.
I love you forever, Redwood Cigarette!
Smoking is just as fun for kids as it is for parents.
Have a Redwood.
Don't let adults have all the fun.
What? Where are you going?
Look the other way, pal. We're fighting communists.
Oh, I hate these communists. They killed my father in Stalingrad. Look in the writer's room. I hear the filthy socialists often meet there.
Oh, Gordon, I'm scared.
Shut up. You'll blow our cover.
Oh, I'm sorry, Gordon. Estrogen makes me weak-minded. minded.
Let's not waste time. We haven't got a moment to lose on dull exposition or silly plot points. I want to go straight to the boss of this place. Vinewood is full of harlots and charlatans and socialist scum, and I want to know who is pulling the strings. We need to have a chat, Bucko.
You've been overdoing the firewater again, huh? We can't afford to pay your kind for movie work. We're losing money. This is advertising money.
I'm no sitting bull, Big Chief Pile of Cash. I'm Gordon Moorhead, crime fighter, and I'm hunting commies, see? Ha! I knew it.
Those aren't mine. They belong to the maintenance man.
A likely story, blaming the honest poor.
I'm sorry, Mr. Zelder. I forgot my artificial hand.
You slipped by this time, but I'm convinced you're running a massive propaganda operation here. One that's hell-bent into turning this country into a bunch of weak-minded, overly considerate Lenin lovers.
Why, that's a bold-faced lie! Actors and movie executives would never push a liberal agenda! We studio bosses are too busy counting money all day and sleeping with young starlets to care about the threat we're putting out! What you need to do is visit the writer's room, yes? That's what you should do. What I need to do is get this young lady out from under my desk! No teeth, damn it!
Oops, sorry, Mr. Zelda. I didn't mean it.
Oh, Gordon, this is so scary!
Shut up. Running out of places to slap you. We're fighting a red menace here. We've got no time for emotion.
What did you do during the war, Gordon?
I fought fascism.
In Germany? Italy?
No, dumbass, Florida. Now shut your yap. We're here. Gadzooks! Someone's making monkeys of us! There must be another writer's room!
Don't worry. I will track them. Over there.
Ha! You're incredible, you savage.
Pablo!
That's not Pablo.
Yes, it is! Igor Pavlovich, rescue at large! Ha ha ha! Comrades! You're too late! Already I have flooded your movies with communist propaganda! Your workers will rise up! Unionize, demand ridiculous wages, and then all American industry will fail and move to communist China. It's good plan, no?
Oh, please. Oh, that is rich. America will always be a pillar of industry. We're unstoppable. Our hunger and work ethic make us invincible. As if America would ever become fat, lazy, and entitled like you commies. And besides, I'm about to stop you.
Oh, that horrible, awful foreigner's getting away! Get him, Gordon!
No, bye-bye, comrades! I fall down!
Pablo!
Hola, Señor Moorhead. Hola, Miss Momstein.
Oh, Pablo, where have you been?
I stopped for siesta, to aburrido.
Such a cunning people. They nap half the day and mix the same four ingredients and give it 20 different names.
Oh, can I get a chimichanga?
Gordon, I bring you a present.
But Pablo, Friendly's no longer a sponsor of this show.
See, but this is old script, muy viejo.
Well, in that case, give me a Redwood, buy me a starter home, and stand the hell back. These people are about to be put on the cutting room floor.
I guess weeding out trouble never goes out of style.
How, muchacho?
And I guess I would like a Redwood.
Join us next time for more adventures with Gordon, Molly, and the gang as they protect America's atomic secrets by setting some off only on Moorhead Rides Again!
Pablo Raybazar makes $28 million a year. Dwayne Aller makes $35 million a year. You make $10 an hour. Failure this deep calls for a deep, slow-brewed beer. Lager, the official beer of American baseball. These guys are at the top of their game. You're at the bottom. Relive your glory days. Have a lager.
Bored? Stupid? How about a fulfilling career as a stunt double? To break into Pinewood, you just might have to break through a windshield. Cunning Stunt Academy.
I'm here for you, boss. 100%. Hi there. How can I help you? Anything to keep you productive, boss.
Captain, what do you think Mr. Rubio is doing right now? If you listen very carefully on sonar, you can hear him screaming. And you're heading, Captain? It's okay, I will fix it.
Barring, spinning eye. Why can't you assholes be on time for once, eh? Arms out, let's go. Okay, wait over there. They will bring it soon. Go on.
As soon as you go beyond the airstrip, you must be careful. If guards get a good look at you while you are in the restricted area, they will know something is not right. Safest thing is to stay out of sight. Okay, I have access. The app is on your phone. Let us take a look.
Thank you.
wrong, you wake up next day with Mexican accent. Diamond encrusted edition too. This will fetch us the price we need. Getting through the case will be a challenge. Use the wrong tool and you destroy what is inside. I will do some research.
Mistake there, buddy. You need this shit in your life. You'll be back.
Thank you.
work, Capitan!
Hey, come up now!
Thank you.
infrared scanner we saw in Mr. Rubio's office is state-of-the-art. Ordinary hacking tools is out of the question, so we have only one option. We find the fail-safe tool. This is the backup which allows for reconstructing Mr. Rubio's fingerprints in emergency, and there is only one in existence, kept safe on the mainland by his head of cybersecurity. This and only this will allow us to hack the system. But first things first, we find his archives. Head to the coordinates I have sent you. Watching it now. Watch out. This place will also have CCTV. The tool you are looking for will be the size of a credit card. Look for something with antennae.
we are to raid Mr. Rubio's drinks cabinet, huh? In Russia, we would never succeed in this.
Goodbye.
me clean. And the closest thing to clean in Los Santos? Stealing from your rivals. I have found a gang who are bringing unregistered shipment. They are from Los Santos, so of course, they are operating out of upmarket skyscraper office. I have sent you location. Was that it? Did it open the locker? No complacency, yes? They will be right behind you. You know, Capitan, in my youth, I would use personal weapons on operations such as this. at your position. I will also access compound CCTV once you are inside. On your own. In Russia, we bring friends, and our friends bring bags. More bags, more money in bags. Perhaps next time, yes? By the way, you will always have room in your bag for main objective. I have crafted special compartment for us. Selective with your looting. If it is too heavy, it will slow you down, perhaps too much. Some advice. When dealing with paranoid drug lords, expect CCTV everywhere. Besides that, Captain, you know, I think Mr. Rubio is best thing that ever happened to us. And we are worst thing ever happened to him, huh? Thank you. general who said that sweeping through the undersea pipeline was closest he felt to inner peace. An interesting man. God rest his soul. So, next up, swimming.
No. ¿Me las tenía que dar? Lo vi hace poco.
Sí. Seguro se lo olvidó ese pendejo.
It would be rude not to check the safe, I think. Good, you are at the scanner. The tool we stole from the head of cybersecurity will find partial prints left on the scanner. You just have to cycle through them to match them up to the target print. Something about coming all this way to steal a bottle of booze, which speaks to me on a very deep level. Bad news. They have sealed the drainage pipe. You will need to look for another way out of there. Sounds of it, Mr. Rubio.
Watch out!
You're just a total douche, Dad. You know that?
What was that?
You heard me!
You're right, Angel. I'm sorry.